Hi everyone. This video is all about measurements and systems of measure. So let's get started. A measurement is the determination of the amount of something. We use the word measurement all the time, right? You're going to use a different tool for any given measurement, and that tool is going to give you two things. It's going to give you a number value, and it's going to give you a unit. And you can see in this picture over here, let me get my face out of the way, that if you're measuring the height of something, you could give a number for that. If you were measuring the height of the dog, 0.6 meters or 2 feet. And you want to make sure that it includes the unit that you're using so that a person who might be replicating your measurement can do so accurately. So in the United States, we have two systems of measurement. One we use more often than the other. The customary system is kind of a mixed bag of different units that are thrown together. They're not necessarily related to one another based on their conversion factors. And so it makes it a little bit harder to remember when you're trying to convert one to the other. If you've ever done any cooking or anything like that, you know that this can be a little bit frustrating because you can never remember how many quarts are in a gallon or, you know, how many teaspoons are in a tablespoon. You always have to look it up. Lucky for you, you do not have to memorize any of the customary units. I will always give those to you if I ask you to solve a conversion problem. But a lot of them you already know. So perhaps you remember that, for example, there are 5,280 feet in 1 mile, or that there are 12 inches in 1 foot. So those are some examples of customary units. In the rest of the world, and in all the scientific applications, or pure science applications anyway, here in our country, we use the metric system. It's also called SI. It comes from the French phrase international system, or system international. And it's a base 10 system, which means that every unit is an order of 10 larger or smaller than the unit next to it. So it's fantastic. It's really easy to use, and really easy to convert one to the other. So for example, 1 decimeter is equal to 10 centimeters, and 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. So again, this makes it really easy to convert one to the other. We also use metric in science because it is really easy to communicate with our scientists in other countries. So if you're publishing a study and someone in Switzerland wants to read it, they can automatically understand the same units that you're using and replicate those units in their own version of that study. All right, so let's take a look at some common units that you'll need to know. And let me get my face out of the way so you can see it. These are important for you to have in your notes. So the spellings are important for you to know, as well as the symbols. And the symbols are case sensitive. So it's really important that you record the proper uppercase or lowercase for each of these. But we use grams for mass, meters for length, liters for volume, newtons for force, and that comes from Isaac Newton. That's an uppercase N. We use degrees Celsius for temperature, and we use seconds for time. All right, so another great thing about metric system is that once you know the units, all you have to do is add on a prefix to that unit to tell how big or how small that unit really is. And the prefixes stay the same regardless of the unit that you use. So in this class, we're going to be memorizing 6 different prefixes. You'll have to know more of them later on, but for now, the ones that you need to know are kilo, hecto, deca, deci, centi, and milli. And those are in order from large to small. So kilo is 1,000 of the base unit value, whereas milli is 1/1,000th of that base unit value. So really, really big to really, really small. You'll notice that the one thing that I want to point out here is deca. Deca has an abbreviation of DA, and that's to differentiate it from deci, which is just D. So if I were to ask you, well, what is the symbol for decaliter? You would need to make sure that you write lowercase d, lowercase a, uppercase L, D-A-L. If I were to ask you what is the abbreviation for centimeter, then you would write lowercase c, lowercase m. So the prefix always goes first, and then the unit goes after. All right, so let's take a look at some ways to estimate these units because these are not units that we use often. If you're talking about length, you can remember that a centimeter is about the width of your pinky finger. It's pretty small, right? You can also think about a ruler and how that centimeter is about that width of your pinky finger. Volume, a milliliter, how much is that? It's about 10 drops of water. So that's not very much. And another thing that I want to point out about volume is that you can have two different categories of volume units. You can have these cubic units, so cubic meters or cubic centimeters, or you can have liter units. So cubic units come from using a ruler, taking an object that has a regular size, like, I don't know, something like this, right? It has a length and a width and a height. And using a ruler and multiplying length times width times height to get the volume. So that's where that cubic number comes from. Whereas you can also measure volume for things like that are liquids, like water, or you can use water to measure the volume of something in a method called displacement. And we'll talk about displacement later, but it's using a graduated cylinder. And you can see the graduated cylinder is this guy right here, this tall, skinny, beaker looking thing. And it has graduations or numbers that are written in really small distances apart from one another so that you can find out where the water level really is. And those are liters or milliliters typically. Oops. All right, so another thing to know is how to convert a cubic centimeter to a milliliter. And luckily, they're a one-to-one ratio. So 1 cubic centimeter is equal to 1 milliliter. All right, so what about mass? 1 gram is about the weight of a large paper clip. And so that's, again, pretty small. And then temperature, the Celsius scale, if you don't spend a lot of time in other countries, the Celsius scale room temperature is 21 degrees. So you can use that to kind of estimate, like, okay, are we talking really hot, really cold? 21 degrees is considered room temperature, which on the Fahrenheit scale would be like 70, 72-ish degrees. Another temperature scale that you will see is the Kelvin scale. And Kelvin does not use the degree symbol. You can see here it's missing from its symbol. And that's on purpose. We don't even say degrees Kelvin, we just say Kelvin. But it's just a slightly offset conversion of the Celsius scale. So 0 degrees Celsius is 273 Kelvin. And we'll talk more about Kelvin a little bit later on, but just know that that's another form of a metric or a base 10 temperature scale.